Yeah, she has been our wonderful guest host all morning. She's made her triumphant return to morning television. Chrissie Swan, everyone.
Triumphant.
Triumphant.
That's a big word, isn't it? I can't see the beautiful Jessica Rowan Arta-Buttress from over my own shoulder. I'll lean back.
You've been such a good sport about things because we've gone slightly overboard.
Oh, you think? I was washing dishes at my house the other day and I heard in the next room the television was on, the project was on, and I said to my sister, did I just hear an ad in the project for me coming on Studio 10?
It was
and
a
I had
countdown.
To go and rewind it. With a bouncing head.
Yes.
Come on, guys.
You're spinning around.
Our Studio 10 symbol became your face.
Yeah. Excruciatingly embarrassing.
At what point did you think, you know what, maybe this is a bit too much? Was it sort of day 7 of the countdown, day 6, day 5, day 3? Was it the spotlight, the glitter cannons, the Alleluia chorus?
Probably when I did a rehearsal for the float that's going to go down Oxford Street after here. I probably thought that's probably pushing it.
Yeah.
I guess the reason why we did it, though, is because, you know, people just fell in love with you on The Circle. You're so real and honest and relatable. Do you miss getting up early and, you know, sharing your life with people in that way?
Oh, that was great. There was something wrong with the oven in that episode with the beautiful Yumi Steins.
Oh. And here you are sharing an ultrasound.
Yes. That was me pregnant with my second child. Oh. I look at my terrible flat hair. I regret that shirt choice too. Oh. It was such a big moment.
Oh. But what is it about? We always seem to go back to appearance rather than...
Yes,
you're
I know.
True, don't you reckon?
True, I know. It's hard not to. Oh. Look, it was a great show and I loved every minute of it. Look. I loved it.
And the logo actually makes a halo around your head, which is something...
I know. Everybody always said that, which was ironic given that I am...
People were reminded of you and, you know, just what you contributed to that show when they watched you in I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here.
Yeah.
A lot of people were wanting you to win.
I know. Isn't that lovely?
Well, you should have won.
I did hear that when I came out. There was all the press was like shock, you know, shock. Whatever, elimination of me, and I thought, isn't that funny? Oh my god, that was terrifying!
I bet it was.
Yeah. That was on day one. There were crocodiles and hippos in that water, and I'm not talking just about me. I couldn't believe it.
No, yeah, I don't know how you did that.
Oh my god.
Aren't hippos all like the biggest killers of people in Africa out of any wild
animal? Yes, because they're huge and angry. They're huge and angry.
So, but what was it really like, that experience?
It was
terrifying.
It was extremely terrifying and it was really, really hard. I won't lie to you, it was harder than I thought it was going to be.
What made it hard?
The deprivation, I think, and the total lack of comfort.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I just didn't have anything to make me feel good.
What did you get out of it? Did you get something?
Well, I got out of it a real appreciation for my beautiful, shiny life that sometimes, you know, is a drag.
Mm.
But now I'm just like, I'm walking around turning on light switches going, it works! There's a roof! I'm having a shower! And, you know, soap!
Coffee!
Oh, my God, and my kids and sheets and all these things we really don't think about. So in that way it was really valuable and it was very difficult, but I think sometimes, you know, life gets very cushy when you get to a certain age and, you know, it's good to be scared and dirty and out of your comfort zone, knowing that, you know, there is an end in sight. I really enjoyed it,
because they take absolutely everything away from you. I think this is often the thing that's hard to get across, but it is a form of torture to be not only just removed from everything that you love and that you're used to, but have everything gone. And you were saying before that, you know, you would get so bored, you'd be crawling up the walls, so to speak, that you would actually be hanging for a challenge where someone would dump elephant dung or maggots or whatever on you just so you'd have something to do.
I volunteered for that challenge where I was covered in, you know, offal because I just wanted to get out of camp.
You know, when you were on The Biggest Loser, you overheard... You overheard a cameraman saying something about your weight. How did you react
well,
to that?
Well, I think that was sort of misreported too. I don't know...
You were new to television.
I don't know... Well, I didn't even feel like I was on television. I was just, you know, a copywriter from Melbourne living in a house. But I was taking my bra off and I heard someone behind me say... I know you like big women.
Oh, God.
I know. And I just was like, what's going on? Are they sending pictures of my boobs to their friends? Like, what? Oh. Have I become someone's fetish? And I did. I felt very vulnerable and, you know, scared. It was awful. But, you know, now, oh, my God.
How do you walk that line, though, Chrissie? I mean, part of the reason why people love you so much is because, you know, you're open-hearted and you wear your heart on your sleeve and, you know, you are sensitive and flawed like so many... Oh, so all of us. Lately. How do you then protect yourself from all the crap that's thrown at you?
Well, you know, I am an imperfect person and I know that about myself. So when someone calls me fat, I know that. I've got a mirror. Tell me something I don't know. That really doesn't bother me, to be honest, because that's like saying I have brown hair.
Mm. Mm. What about, like, we were really bothered on your behalf when people had a go at you going into the jungle and leaving your kids. And
that was absurd,
yes,
wasn't it?
Well, I mean, how did you feel later when you heard all that nonsense?
Well, my partner told me that and initially I was, you know, upset because I thought, oh, that's annoying because that's not true. But then I just felt how stupid when I realised that the vast majority of people realised that was a stupid statement to judge somebody for working when they are a woman in 2015. You know, the onus was on the person that said that, nothing to do with me.
That's right. The dumber you are, the more you've got to say.
There is your beautiful
partner.
There is your beautiful partner in Leo. We've got so much to learn from you, Chrissie. You're such a wonderful, wonderful woman. It's great to have you on the couch for the next couple of days.
So glad to be here. I'm so excited.